மார்னிங், ஐ ஆம் சிவயோகி சிவராஜன், திருமூலர் யோக சித்தப்பீடம், கோயம்புத்தூர். நவ் ஐ ஆம் கோயிங் டு ஸ்பீக் அபவுட் மூன் யோகா. மூன் யோகா இஸ் ஃபெமிலியர் டு தி வெஸ்டர்ன் வேர்ல்ட் ஒன்லி ஆஃப்டர் 1960. த பீகார் ஸ்கூல் ஆஃப் யோகா introduced this yoga to the Western world. Then only people became familiar with the moon yoga. But before 5000 years, Saint Thirumoolar has written about this moon yoga in his book Thirumandira. He has written 3000 verses in Thirumandira. In this, 33 verses deal with moon yoga. These yogas are based on Shiva agamas, particularly Viragama. The Viragama deals with different kinds of yogas. One among them is Andhra Yoga, called Moon Yoga. In the Moon Yoga, there are so many asanas, pranayama and Chandra Namaskara there. Just like Surya Namaskar practiced in other yogas, here Chandra Namaskar, Moon Yoga Namaskar is practiced. Just like we have 12 positions in Surya Namaskar, we are having 15 positions in Chandra Yoga. The Surya Namaskar is done in the morning to facing the sun. In the same way, Chandra Namaskar is done in the evening facing the moon. The Surya Namaskar increases body heat, whereas the Chandra Namaskar cools down the body. When you do Surya Namaskar, you tell the different names of Surya, cite as mantras, and do. The same way, in the Moon Yoga, you cite the different names of Chandra, the moon, during Namaskar. While doing Surya Namaskar, you get solar energy and it is accumulated in the solar plexus. In Chandra Yoga, lot of lunar energy is received in the right brain of man. In the Surya Namaskar, movements are fast. In Chandra Namaskar, slow movements and very easy movements are done. Surya Namaskar improves the body activity, whereas Chandra Namaskar improves the intelligence. In the same way, some other asanas are particularly chosen for the Chandra Namaskar, Chandra Moon Yoga. They are normally, they give coolness to the body. They are Artha Chandra Asana, Anjaneya Asana, Ustra Asana, சகஜ புஜங்காசனா, விபரீத வீரபத்ர ஆசனா, சோமச்சந்திர ஆசனா, அஞ்சலி முத்ராஸ் ஆர் ஆல்சோ ப்ராக்டிஸ்ட். சம் மோர் ஆசனாஸ் ஆர் தேர் அக்கார்டிங் டு தி ஏஜ் அண்ட் மெச்சூரிட்டி. வி ரெக்கமெண்ட் தி ஆசனாஸ் ஃபார் லேர்னிங் ஆல் தீஸ் மூன் யோகா. யூ கேன் கான்டாக்ட் மிஸ்டிக் திருமூலா அட் gmail.com. mystictirumoola@gmail.com. The same way, some pranayamas are also done. These pranayamas also aim to cool down the body. There are many breathing exercises. They are called as sthula pranayama. When you do this breathing exercise, your body will automatically pick up your voluntary system, and it is called Sushma Pranayama. In this pranayama, in moon salute, moon yoga, you see Sidali Pranayama, Sitkari Pranayama, Brahmari Pranayama, they all cool down the body. In the same way, Chandra Veda, Surya Namaskara, Chandra Veda Pranayamam is done. Surya Veda increases body heat, Chandra Veda Pranayamam cools down the body. So, in the moon yoga, when you practice during waxing time of moon, it gives more benefit. During waxing time, you receive a lot of lunar energy. Particularly on the ninth day, you receive more energy. The waxing time, the energy is received by the astral body, and through the astral body, it is transferred to the physical body. The astral body, there are 72,000 nadis. They are astral tubes. They receive the energy and give to the nervous system in the physical body. Thus, the physical body receives the lunar energy. When it receives this energy, it is good for health also. This hymn 851 says, when prana ascends to moon kala, it turns subtle. The two breaths, though through ida and pingala, runs gross. They rise and fall unto the kalas that wax and wane. Pure is the subtle, gross is that runs in the body. This is the hymn 851, English translation. The 72,000 nadis thus give energy to the physical body. They transfer the lunar energy to the physical body. The Agni has got 10 kalis. The sun has got 12 kalis. And moon has got 16 kalis. They are principles. This is described in hymn 852 of Tirumandaram. 16 the kalis of moon, 12 the sun and 10 of the fire. The yogi experiences them all in the upward journey of prana through susumna, and all that becomes his mystic knowledge. So, these he explains the number of colors of the Agni, Surya and Chandra. Now, the practice of moon yoga, the 10 colors of fire are absorbed by the 12 colors of sun. And the 12 kalais will be absorbed by the 16 kalais of moon. That is what happens in the Chandra Yoga. In hymn 853, he says, the 12 kalais of sun absorbs the 10 of fire. Together they are absorbed in the 16 kalais of moon. Those who have learned to merge in moon's color verily become masters of earth. When you do this Chandra Yoga, you become a perfect yogi and you become master of earth. So, the practice of moon yogi should meditate on Lord Shiva. The meditation should be concentrated on Lord Shiva because it is a Shiva Tantra Yoga. Whatever Tirumula says is Shiva Tantra Yoga. So, the meditation of Lord Shiva is very important. So, this is told in hymn number 857. All kalais from the left and right nadis pass through the central nadi. Kindle the Kundalini fire in Mooladhara. They reach the cranium at top to pay homage at the feet of Godly One. So, Shiva meditation is also very important. Then what happens is, the moon yogi brings bright above the forehead. when he practices moon yoga, this a kind of light in the astral body will be developed above the forehead of the Chandra Yogi. When you practice this moon yoga, the five senses will come under control and you will hear the quenched sound of Lord Shiva. Om, sound of Lord Shiva. This is told in hymn 865. 12 the female kalais of sun, 16 the male kalais of moon, sees them both sitting unmoved, and consign them to the Kundalini fire. In that yoga, wells of ecstasy beyond recount. So, when you do this, you hear the sound as well as the five senses come under control. For any yogi, anyone who practices yoga, the control or restraint of five senses are very important. That is also very important for Chandra Yogi. When the yogi will finally reach the lotus feet of Lord Shiva. It is told in hymn 880. If with mind centered they hold their breath in direction of nada sound that from Shiva's konje emanates, five senses that run blind build there and intermittent bliss of delectable nectar leaves them not ever. So, moreover, the practice, when you practice Chandra Yoga, your breathing will be elongated. Normally, as and when age advances, this breathing will come down. When you are a child, full breathing will be there. As and when age advances, the breathing process will be slowed down, and the breathing becomes less and less. Normally, 12-inch breathing is told in Siddha literature. Below Visuddha, 8-inch breathing is done, and above Visuddha, 4-inch breathing goes up to brain. Then only the Sahasra will be activated. This is told in hymn 876. The waxing colors of Kalai 6 of sun, the waning Kalai 6 of moon, woke to life the 12 angular running. When the moon dropped out, who knows this? When this improvement in breathing process will be done in moon yoga. So, the same way the Chandra Yogi practices the control of semens also. Any yogi should control the flow of semens. They should not waste semens frequently. They should have restraint over sex. The semens will be arrested in Mooladhara in Chandra Yoga. Then only he will get brightness overhead. The lunar energy will be received most in the right brain. This he says in hymn 877. The yogi's saman flows not where it less. Devoid of passions, it finds collects in Mooladhara. Chanting Om in heart's silentness, he remains pure, awareness filled. So, this is very important for Chandra Yogi. In the same way, the Chandra Yogi will enjoy the Somapana, that is the nectar from lunar energy. Normally, this Chandra Somapana is identified with melatonin secretion. When it secretes, he will get perfect knowledge called jnana. The same way, he will transcend time. Transcend time. That is, he will know past and future. He says in hymn 875, they traverse spheres of sun and moon and see vision of past, present and future earth. And in that full moon days the nectar ripens. Until the moon drops back from Kundalini, time stands to a stop. He says in this hymn. Moreover, the moon yogi will live for a long time, because when you achieve perfectness in yoga, your body will be fit for living long. You will be more healthy than ordinary persons, and you can live for a long time. This he says in hymn 866. Holds the breath running in sun's nadi in the right, to the moon's nadi in the left, and vice versa. If you can do this erring not, you may live a 1,000 years. This body will preserved be, he says in this hymn. Moreover, ultimately, the yogi will become Shiva himself. In Saiva Siddhanta, the Jiva slowly becomes Shiva. Stage by stage it becomes Shiva himself. Whatever you meditate, you will become that. In the same way, if you practice these Shiva yogas, you will become Shiva. This is told in hymn 874. The yogis who thus practices incessant conquers death, they rise to the level of Lord Shiva. So when he reaches this stage, the Chandra Yoga or Moon Yoga becomes fulfilled. Thank you.